Dear Ronnie, you are the love of my life, and I truly think that I couldn't find someone like you. So like you, I'm gonna make this short and sweet. Ronnie, you bring out the very best in me and see me for who I am, and I love you so much for that. I always knew I was gonna marry you ever since your first year in college. You are my rock, my soulmate, you're my everything, and I won't go a day for the rest of my life not loving you. And I promise to always be there when you need me, no matter how big or how small, I'll always be there. I love you so much. I can't wait to see you in that beautiful dress. I love you so much. Can't wait to see you in T-minus an hour and a half.
Dylan, I love you. I want to be with you. Dylan Michael McGinnis, we're getting married. No, but for real though, today's the day, babe. I love you so much. I can't believe that I'm so lucky. I get to marry my best friend, love of my life, and most importantly, the best man ever. Can't wait to see you. I'll meet you at the altar. Love you forever, Ronnie. I love you. Can't wait to see you. And spend the rest of our lives together.
Beautiful as I imagined. Wow, look, you're so happy. I'm glad. How you doing? I'll wait. That's right. Beautiful. Wow. Wow.
Good afternoon and welcome. As we gather together to celebrate the sacrament of marriage of Dylan and Veronica. And so let us pray. O God, who in creating the human race willed that man and wife should be one, join, we pray, in a bond of inseparable love these your servants who are to be united in the covenant of marriage, so that as you make their love fruitful, they may become by your grace witnesses to charity itself. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated for the proclamation of God's word. Our first reading will be proclaimed by Colin.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air. And he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be his name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals. But none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up the place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This woman, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife. And the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. And if I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It is not jealous. It is not pompous. It is not inflated. It is not rude. It does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered. It does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Glory to you, Lord. Jesus said, "From the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. You may be seated. My friends, it's with great thanksgiving and joy that we celebrate today the marriage of Dylan and Veronica. We are thankful because we are privileged to witness God at work in their lives. And we celebrate with joy because Dylan and Veronica are beginning a new life together, a life that has been born of the love between a man and a woman, but also a love that is greater than the love each brings to it. Today, as our first reading reminds us, the two of you will become one body. And that means that you can no longer think of yourself without thinking of the other, your spouse. And this is a great commitment. But from such a commitment, many blessings flow, blessings that were not otherwise possible. Even so, recognize that the commitment you embark on today may not always be easy. In those times, recall the devotion you claim for one another today. And remember that God has also that same devotion for you as husband and wife in even greater measure. In your daily living, you are to confirm on each other that generous and freely given love. It is the love of which St. Paul speaks so wonderfully about in our second reading. It is not self-seeking, but rather self-giving. And when you think of Christ's love for us, we are brought to the notion of sacrificial love, a love so profound that one willingly gives his or her life away in order to save another. The marital bond which you will enter and the love to which it calls you is just like that. Each of you is now entrusted or covenanted to the other, which means that the greatest responsibility you each of you have to your spouse is to help them get to heaven. Christ's sacrificial love cleared that path to heaven, and now it is your responsibility as husband and wife to ensure that the other travels that path well. And in doing so, you will demonstrate to all of us the model of Christian love. And so, in the words of St. Paul, Dylan and Veronica, may you put on love and manifest that love to the world in a wonderful way. May you always be one as Christ and his Father are one. And may we all continue to see in your marital love the unconditional love of God, the love that will one day bring us all to perfection and ultimate happiness in him. Congratulations. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses that love. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you, Dylan and Veronica, to state your intention. Dylan and Veronica, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely, and wholeheartedly?
Yes.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live? Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Yes. Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. Dylan, do you take Veronica for your lawful wife to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part?
I do.
Veronica, do you take Dylan for your lawful husband to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish until death do you part? You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, man must not divide. All right. May I have the rings, please? Bless, O Lord, these rings which we bless in your name, that those who wear them will remain entirely faithful to each other, abide in peace and in your will, and live always in mutual charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. All right. Okay. Take that, place that on her finger. And repeat after me. Veronica. Receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Okay. Dylan, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay. You have auras. Okay. May I have the auras, please? The auras. The coins. If the assembly will please stand. Dear brothers and sisters, as we call to mind the special gift of grace and charity by which God has been pleased to crown and consecrate the love of our sister Veronica and our brother Dylan, let us commend them to the Lord.
For the church throughout the world, may our faith in the love God has for us be expressed in our love for one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in our world, may all lands that suffer violence and injustice find peace and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor, the homeless, and for those who are unemployed, may our care and concern for those in need be a sign of God's love. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the protection and the sanctity of human life from conception until natural death, may all people be treated with the dignity they deserve as God's children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Dylan and Veronica, who begin their married life together this day, may they experience the love of God, the support of family and friends, and the blessings of children. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, especially the relatives and friends of Dylan and Veronica, and of all present for this wedding, may they enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in an eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Graciously pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those you have filled with your blessing. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated for the presentation of the gifts. Will you please stand? Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you willed that the human race, created by the gift of your goodness, should be raised to such high dignity that in the union of husband and wife, you might bestow a true image of your love. For those you created out of charity, you call to the law of charity without ceasing, and grant them a share in your eternal charity. And so the sacrament of holy matrimony, as the abiding sign of your own love, consecrates the love of woman, of man and woman, through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes, the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel or be seated as you wish. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior. Save us, Savior. Save us, Savior.
Save us, Lord. 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 Save
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop and all the clergy. Be mindful also, Lord, of Dylan and Veronica, whom you have brought to their wedding day, so that by your grace they may abide in mutual love and peace. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. May I have the lasso and the veil, please? Bless, O Lord, this lasso and this veil, the symbol of the indissoluble union that Dylan and Veronica have established from this day forward before you and with your help. Okay. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to the Lord that on these his servants now married in Christ, he may mercifully pour out the blessing of his grace and make of one heart in love he has joined by a holy covenant. O God, who by your mighty power created all things out of nothing, and when you had set in place the beginnings of the universe, formed man and woman in your own image, making the woman an inseparable helpmate to the man, that they might not longer be two but one flesh, and taught that what you were pleased to make one must never be divided. O God, who consecrated the bond of marriage by so great a mystery, that in the wedding covenant you foreshadowed the sacrament of Christ and his church. O God, by whom woman is joined to man, and the companionship they had in the beginning, is endowed with the one blessing not forfeited by original sin, and were washed away by the flood. Look now with favor on these your servants, joined together in marriage, who ask to be strengthened by your blessing. Send down on them the grace of the Holy Spirit and pour your love into their hearts, that they may remain faithful in the marriage covenant. May the grace of love and peace abide in your daughter Veronica, and let her always follow the example of those holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband entrust his heart to her, so that acknowledging her as his equal and his joint heir to the life of grace, he may show her due honor and cherish her always with the love that Christ has for his church. And now, Lord, we implore you, may these your servants hold fast to the faith and keep your commandments, made one in flesh. May they be blameless in all they do. And with the strength that comes from the gospel, may they bear true witness to Christ before all. May they be blessed with children and prove themselves virtuous parents who live to see their children's children. And grant that reaching at last together the fullness of years for which they hope, they may come to the life of the blessed in the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Please kneel or be seated as you wish. Just a short note about Holy Communion. For those of you who may not be Roman Catholic, when people come forward for communion, you're welcome to remain seated. Or if you wish to receive a blessing, I'm happy to do that. Please just come forward with your arms crossed over your chest like so, and I'd be happy to give you a blessing. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
See the good. to move over there. Wait, let's I'll push over there.
Can remove the veil and the lasso at this time. Please stand and let us pray. By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor what in your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love those you have already joined in this holy union. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The bride and the groom will now take flowers to Mary. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. May God the eternal Father keep you of one heart in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. May you be blessed in your children, have solace in your friends, and enjoy true peace with everyone. Amen. May you be witnesses in the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. And may Almighty God bless all of you gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm pleased to introduce to you for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Dylan McGinnis. You may kiss your bride.
Everybody's talking up here, but the first time they met Ronnie, I met her first. ever since then, it's been great. There's challenges in bringing up kids, but I've been lucky. With my wife as my partner, we've had a good time. And you make us happy. You've always been driven. You always achieve. You don't give up. You got both of us. You got her as far as ability to do things when they got to be done now, yesterday. And you got my ability of being able to meet people and just talk to anybody, whenever. You do that. Even though we both say that we're kind of shy. I don't know why, but we do. I'm shy. But just a little. Now also, I was told to keep it short because somebody has to pay. But no, we're very happy that you guys came because it'd be a wedding, it'd be a gathering, but this party belongs because you guys came here to make it a party, a happy party, a joyous party. Today, my family got twice as big. I got to meet a lot of you guys. I do have to. And of course. And so, like I said, we moved to Texas about 11 years ago. It's a different life out here in Texas, but we love it. We have a good time. And when I met this guy here, his impression, he came in and said, "Hey, Pops." Not a good thing. Ronnie said, "What are you doing?" She was frozen, like in fear. But I tell you what, he is right here. And that's a term of endearment for me. He's the guy who's put the Pops on me. And I'm all right with that. He's a good guy. He is quiet, but he gets things done. Always.
Hard worker.
Never complains about work. He just does it. And so between both of them, they're going to achieve a lot. And I guess in closing, today, the world may have lost a Villa Blaze, but it gained a McGinnis. That's a good thing.
Yes.
So put your drinks up. Put your
I didn't. welcome to our family. It has been a long time coming. We're very happy to welcome you. Dylan, I love you very much. She's a beautiful young lady. Big heart to match your big heart. Y'all are gonna do magical things, wonderful things. I'm very happy, very proud of you both. Thank you for having such a wonderful daughter, raising her wonderfully. She is so magical. And welcome to our family. We love you. Dylan and Ronnie.
If you know me, I'm not a speech maker, by no means. The people that know me, I am not one to get up here and talk. But this young lady is the light of his life, okay? I commend you on the young lady that you have made, that you have developed. I tease my children, and all four of them are here. She's my favorite child. And as I instructed him this evening after the nuptials were done, she is technically now my favorite child. She's a beautiful young lady. He's a beautiful young man. That goes back to y'all and to the grandmother. It starts in the roots. Y'all done a wonderful job. She is a very driven young lady. She will achieve things beyond our scope. She is just there. And I wish them nothing but the best in life. And if you know me, it takes a lot for me to make a speech. I am not that person. I'm the one in the back of the room. But good luck. I love you both to death.
You should let go, you hold on, the way out to you. Thank you for the blessing of bringing Dylan and Veronica together in marriage today. We ask you to bless their marriage, their family, and all their relationship. Help them stay strong in any adversity and as a treasury and protect the joy of marriage. May we ask their family and friends commit, uphold, and encourage them to be the best of our ability. Please bless this food we are about to receive, and let the reception be an honor for you. In Jesus' name, thank God to be together and enjoy the party.
Cheesy thing I've ever said. I'm gonna start by saying that because I don't say cheesy things very often, especially not to Ronnie, because we have this very strange relationship. But words cannot describe how blessed I am to know you, how lucky I was to watch you grow into this beautiful woman you are before me. Sorry. Thanks. It all started about 5 years ago. We met Ronnie at orientation, Harley and I. Yeah, Harley's crying now. Look, this never happens. Somebody take a picture, please. Please. We met Ronnie, and we went to go get some lunch, and we were walking by the salad bar, and Harley and I started walking off because we've known each other since we were little. And Harley goes, "Sarah, should we wait for her?" And I turned back, and I looked. And Ronnie was standing there waiting for her salad, and she looked over at us, and I was like, "Yeah, all right." And now look, here we are, 5 years later, all because we waited at the salad bar. Thank you, Harley, because otherwise I'd have been gone. And I'm so, so grateful, because I don't know what my life would be like without you. And I'm so happy to be, like, to know you. And I know everybody in this room feels the same way, to know Veronica Villablaze. Dylan, you're cool too. You know, it's no worry.
Yeah.
Very cool. Without the silly TikToks that you send us every day, your Harry Potter obsession, thank you, your ability to nap anywhere and everywhere, the little stutter you have when you write, and your capability to hoard an entire cabinet of cups and bowls in your room. I do know that my college experience gave me a lifelong friend. Harley, Ronnie, and I, we always say that our relationship is quite strange, like I said. Being in a room with all three of us, you would be a little confused by how much we really care for each other, because our actions don't always show it, in a noticeable manner, that is. I'll never forget when I came home from hanging out with some friends to find Harley and Ronnie in the living room, dressed in all black, with paper bags over their head, dancing. And I walked in and I was like, "What are you doing?" And they were like, "Oh, dang it." I was like, "What? Like, did I interrupt something here?" And they're like, "Oh, we were gonna come find you on the Find My iPhone and scare you while you were walking out to your car." Y'all, they had tennis rackets in their hands. I was like, "What?" Like, that is just how we do. I don't understand it and I don't know how to describe it, but that is how we are to each other. And it is very weird. But like I said, I love you very much. And I'm very happy to be here. I'm very sad that we won't be able to pull any more all-nighters at IHOP with the $2 unlimited coffee. And it's silly memories like those that I will always treasure. While writing this speech, I realized how much you really mean to me. and I wrote it on the plane, and the lady sitting next to me said, "Sweetheart, are you okay?" And I was like, "Ma'am, my sister is getting married tomorrow, because that's what you are to me. I don't know what I am to you, but to me, you're like a sister, and I love you, okay?" So thank you.
So I'm going to start off with the first time that I met Ronnie. It was freshman year orientation. I was meeting Sarah for lunch, like she said, and she had brought just some random girl with her. I was like, all right, cool, like, here we go. This is college, right? And, you know, then we almost left her at the salad bar, and then luckily God was looking out and told me to say, hey, maybe we should wait for this girl. And, you know, we sat down, and we were doing all the little small talk things that everyone does when they first meet someone. And I remember she was sharing all of her little stories, and I remember afterward, me and Sarah were like, dang, this girl must really like her boyfriend because she just keeps talking about him. And that was Dylan. And obviously for good reason, because look, and here we are. But, you know, she kept showing us all these prom photos of them and how excited she was for him to come up and help her move in and do all that. And here we are. So I guess it all worked out. But then after that, me and Ronnie were roommates for 3 years. And I've learned quite a few little quirks about her. One of which was, anytime that you get into a car with her, I'd suggest you buckle up because you're want to feel secure when she gets her road rage. another thing is, and then another thing is that if you always want to check the hood of her car because she might leave her phone on it and then take off and then it go flying across the street and get run over by about 20 other cars. And then another thing is, if you're ever missing any dishes, it's probably in her room. But all of these things are what make Ronnie Ronnie, and I wouldn't change a single thing about that. And honestly, that is something that I've definitely learned about Dylan over the years, too. And he doesn't talk all too much, unless it's about Xbox, but... PlayStation. Sorry. But no matter what Ronnie does, something that I've learned about Dylan is that he's just sitting there with his head saying, yep, that's my girl. And he just loves every little bit of her. And for that, I think you're going to be a great husband to Ronnie. And I think it's super important in a person's life, like, to be able to let them, like, their significant other be themselves. And with all their craziness, and I know you'll never make her change, and I thank you so much for that, because I don't know where I'd be without her. And something else that I've learned about Ronnie is that she does really have a very big heart. You know, no matter what, she's always going to be there for her people. And even if she doesn't want to do something, and even if she has a lot on her plate, she's still going to make time for the other people. And, you know, for that, I think she's going to be an amazing wife. I think she's going to be eventually a great mother. And it makes her an amazing friend. And I very much appreciate the friendship that we have. And I thank you for letting me be a part of your life. And even though with all my crazy quirks and all my, you know, annoyingness. But I hope you let me stick around. And I wish y'all the best. I think y'all complement each other very well. And cheers to y'all and y'all's next adventure.
I think this is one of those occasions that's been a long time coming. And it's really just been a matter of when, not if. I want to take a quick moment to appreciate all of the people that made this day possible. Miss Beth and Mr. Villablaze, thank you for making and raising an incredible little girl. Miss Stacy and Mr. Mike, thank you for raising a true gentleman that I feel confident will always take care of my bestie girl. And to the incredibly long list of people that are here today, you are top tier. Thank y'all for being here and making this day special. For those of you that may not know me, I'm Emily. I'm one of the maids of honor. also known as the college sorority friend. Okay, you got the roommates, college sorority friend. I basically filled in as the long distance relationship during the 4-ish years that we were in Arkansas. Interestingly enough, I do not play the boyfriend role in our friendship. That is all her. She's the one that changed my tire in the freezing rain while I was at work. In fact, Ronnie is literally the best boyfriend and sister that I could ever have asked for. There are a lot of moments in this friendship that make me think about how everything in this life truly occurs for a reason. That things don't merely happen to us because we're unlucky. In fact, they happen because they're helping us become who we're meant to be. Ronnie and I's relationship started in sorority world, so that's where I'll start too. When a new freshman goes through recruitment, it's literally one of the worst weeks of her life. maybe right next to the week leading up to her wedding. Here's the thing, recruitment sucks, but you find your best friends for life. Getting rejected is the worst, but you end up with the people who accept you for who you truly are. And while it's almost never where you thought you'd end up, it's always where you're meant to be. As the story goes, Ronnie was almost in another sorority, but she ended up choosing Alpha Chi Omega at the last minute. Fate somehow decided that two random girls belonged in the same chapter that were from the general vicinity of Dallas on opposite ends of the Metroplex, destined to be besties. Ronnie was and still is this incredible, fun, larger-than-life crazy person that pulled these impressive dance tricks at the Alpha Chi new member retreat while wearing a bright yellow minion onesie. It's iconic to this day. We officially started becoming close friends in the spring of freshman year when we had a dance event called Greek Sing. The rest is kind of history and a blur of good times, hard times, dance moves, and bestie vibes only. I met Dylan for the first time one of the years when we came back to Dallas for the A&M Arkansas game in Arlington. Ronnie promised to pick me up only to find out that then I literally lived an hour away on the opposite side of town. They graciously made the drive and Dylan eventually pulled into my driveway in his giant black pickup truck. Dylan is patient. Oh, my bad. It was red in his red truck. Dylan is patient, and most of the time, if you don't hear his thoughts, he's nice. But most importantly, he's good people. He's really the best of people. It doesn't take long before you can see that they really have this yin-yang match. This I hate you so much that I will always love you match. This match that can really only be described as something fate put together. You never initially look at their relationship and say, oh, what cuties, they're so in love. That's so not how they are. They're bros, they're partners in crime, they're ride or die, and they're Ronnie and Dylan. They frankly don't care about putting on a show to display their love, contrary to this event, clearly, to anyone's standards but their own, and that's one of my favorite parts about them. What I know to be true about Dylan is that he's one of those people that's an anchoring force. He brings comfort, safety, and home to the people that he cares about. He's not perfect, but who is? Ronnie and Dylan have the kind of passionate love that makes me understand how to dislike and also love beyond law. Law of man, law of God, law of the universe. Nah, these two are gonna make it. They got a plan. Literally, there's a plan for the zombie apocalypse, okay? So watch out, because the McGinnises are bringing the guns, okay? What I know to be true about Ronnie is that there's more to her than a minion costume and a laugh, and a bunch of confidence that shows on the outside. Deep, 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 deep down, she leaves approximately a small handful of spots for the people she cares deeply about. She loves those people with such vigor and protection that it leaves you feeling complete beyond words. She loves with a sense of loyalty that you just know she's sticking around even if there's a body to bury. She loves with tenacity and a lot of it. She's an incredibly hard worker and she doesn't give up easily. I think many of us know that sometimes this makes her stubborn and nearly impossible to deal with. But it also makes her a badass. She's someone I look up to and someone I'm grateful to know and someone I'm incredibly lucky to love. She will certainly never be my baby girl. She'll never be my childhood bestie or the girl that got me through high school. But she does, many of you are in this room. But she does get to be the best friend, my best friend, that ended up in the exact right place at the exact right time in my life now. And today she became your wife. So cheers to that. Cheers to an incredible pair. Cheers to the McGinnises.
Dude, all right. I'm not gonna sit up here and talk about all the dumb times that me and Dylan had together. You know, I've known Dylan for a long time, most of our life. I've actually known him for almost 20 years now. And get your finger out of your nose. Dig, 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 dig. No, but really, I'm not going to talk about all the dumb times we had together, all the stupid things we've done as teenagers, as adults nowadays, but I'm going to talk about the good things. I'm going to talk about when I'm dumb enough to blow a tire at 2:30 in the morning in Wiley, and Dylan's in Greenville, and I call him and say, hey, I don't have a jack, and he goes, I'm on my way. No thought, no anything, just I'm on my way. When my little brother accidentally, his car dies at work. He's 45, 50 minutes away from Dylan. Hey, Dylan, you know, my car died. I need a ride. I'm on my way. You know, we're just his friends. We're just guys that, you know, hang out with him. Imagine what he's going to do for that one. He'd come out at 2:30 in the morning and help me out. I'm just a guy that he knows. She is the one he put a ring on. He didn't put a ring on my finger, shoot. That ain't for him, I promise. But he got on his knee, he told that woman he loves him, and he asked him to marry her. And it was, you know, the best, probably one of the best moments of your life. I wasn't there. You know, I was sitting at home because I didn't even know it happened. Yeah, I'm the guy that he goes, Ronnie goes, hey, I'm engaged. And I went, wait, what? I've known my best friend for 20 years, and his fiance had to tell me he was engaged. No, you did not tell me. Ronnie told me. Ronnie sent me the video, all right? Ronnie told me. Calm down. You can have the time to talk in a minute. It's my turn right now. But seriously, not first. I've been talking for a while, but I want to thank everybody for being here. You know, everybody raise your glasses for the guests. Thank you for everybody being here. Next, I want to thank Mr. Mike, Stacy. I can't see. Stacy. And then Mike and your wife. Thank you for everything you've done tonight, everything you did last night, everything. Because, I mean, I didn't pay for my tab last night. I hope somebody did, but I didn't pay for my tab last night. But I'm going to leave it at this. Dylan, Ronnie, I'm happy for you. I can't wait for all the memories that y'all make together, all the memories that you make together with your friends. And let's go Cowboys. All right, y'all have a good night. Enjoy yourselves. I'm out. Thank you.
dance floor. Let's get all the single men on the dance floor. Let's get all the single fellas on the dance floor. Two, three.
Said you had me feeling lonely, so you're sleeping.